February is the month of love, and our first guest this morning says you're never too old to find it. More and more older adults are dating during their golden years.
So here with more on what seniors should know is aging expert Anthony Cirillo. Hello, sir, and this is a great topic. How are you doing today?
I'm doing well.
Good morning, Anthony. Yep. Okay, so there are a lot of reasons why more seniors are dating these days. There's an increased divorce rate, of course. People are living longer, and you do believe seniors should be out there dating.
Absolutely. Yeah. So let's go through it. You know, 50s, 60s, 70s, my mother, God love her, bless her soul, she was in her 80s, she was still dating, right? So, you know, people go through ups and downs. They've raised kids. We talked last month, they raised grandchildren, mm-hmm. you know, and so it's kind of becomes their time. So, you know, why not? You know, we also have this thing, women outlive men. We know that. It's genetics. So, you know, when I go sing in the senior communities, I tell the guys, you got it made here. It's six women to one. I mean,
the odds are good.
So you have that. And then, you know, frankly, you know, last week we were up in Philly and we were visiting our kids and our grandkids and we love it. But my wife and I got in the car, you know, Monday to come home and says, you know, the love and companionship of each other,
yes,
you know, is something yes. that you can't replace with kids and grandkids. Mm-hmm. It's all a different kind of thing. So, yeah, absolutely. People need to have love and companionship no matter what their age.
So let's talk about love and companionship, the benefits of senior dating, you know, just kind of eradicating the aloneness.
Yeah, so that's certainly part of it. And, you know, so one of the things I talk about is people who live quality lives as they age have broad social networks. They have, you know, groups that they hang out with. And even today, you know, we have a whole group of people that we hang with, and we've seen, you know, widows and widowers, and we've seen relationships develop. But how much different is that when we were kids, when you would go out on group dates, right? And everybody would be together, and then you kind of filter off. So if nothing else, just the idea of relieving the isolation and getting out with people is important. But then again, social isolation, we've talked about this in the before, huge numbers. So you can't deny that. You need people to get out and find that. But there's also a freedom that comes with all this at this age, right? You're unencumbered in many ways. Mm-hmm. You don't have different deadlines and pressures on you. And so that really just puts a new face on a relationship. And you kind of, at this point in the game, you know what you want, you know who you want, you know what kind of things you want. So it's just a different dynamic.
That's true. What is a good way for seniors to go out and meet people?
Okay, so I met my wife in a nightclub 33 years ago, but I was playing, so I'm not as in tune with this, but I was playing in a band and she came out to watch me. But, you know, I think the idea of a club is something that you can talk about, you know, where people have different interests, and so how do you tap into those interests? So, you know, laundry list of things you can get involved in, right? There's theater groups, there's wine clubs, there's painting with wine, there's trips and excursions, there's volunteer opportunities. So, you know, you can go down that whole meetup thing and go down. And really, I think it's more in this day and age about finding your interest and then pursuing them and then meeting like-minded people, because it's going to be more compatible much more quickly.
Yes, those kinds of clubs, not like the club.
I will say I do know some people my age who still go to the club.
So. Ain't nothing wrong with that. If that's your thing, go for it.
Go to the club then. So how was dating different from now with seniors now to when they were younger?
So a lot essentially, it's not, but there's this old Frank Sinatra song that says, you know, love is lovelier the second time around, just as wonderful with both feet on the ground. And I think the both feet on the ground thing is important. You know, you're a little more stable. You kind of know what you want. You know, it may not be as much about appearance as I just talked about compatibility, though I do joke, my mom, and she did date into her 80s, and you know, her criteria is you had to be able to dance and dress well. And if you didn't have one or the other, you were out. And so there was also expectations, too, less expectations at this point. You know, it's not about pressure to get married or living together. My mother said, I'm not cooking a pot of gravy for that guy. You know, she had
If she was
still with us, I would bring her on the show because she would be much more entertaining than I could ever be. So it's a different expectation, different, you know, of how you go about, you know, doing this. But I do think one of maybe the basic things is a little more, you have to be safe, right, in this day and age. So, you know, where you go, how you meet. You know, telling people that you're out there. And if you're using dating apps, you have to watch for the scams, right? There's going to be people who are posers, who are out there, and they're going to tell you they love you, and then this, and then that, and then please send money. You know, that kind of thing.
Right. Be careful for all of those things. There's more to talk about, but I'm told that we are out of time. So for more information, check out. I know. I'm just following the rules. theagingexperience.com. Go there for more information.